Hi guys, welcome to Lingovest. I'm Laura and today I'm going to teach you three tips and tricks that will help you understand native speakers. Because sometimes they have such accents or speak so fast that we non-native English speakers feel totally lost. When I was 19, I traveled to Ireland and I stayed with a local family and went to a local English school. And it was then that I realized I had no idea about English. It was all Greek to me. Hi, how are you doing?
Oh God, it's desperate. God, the mountains is brave and close now, right enough. Oh God, it's wild time of the snow, all right.
Oh Lord. Yep. And it was then that I understood that the English my English language teachers used in the class, that kind of word by word, fully pronounced English, does not really apply much to the real English we hear in the streets. Therefore, since I had big trouble trying to communicate with locals or just getting what they were trying to say, I said to myself, listen, I need to change my listening techniques. So I started coming up with new ones, and those are the techniques I'm going to be sharing with you today. So make sure that you hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell to be notified when there is a new lesson ready for you. And now let's see what we can do to improve our listening skills. The more you know about the way native people speak, the easier it'll be for you to understand what they say and even to imitate the way they sound. So the first tip to improve your listening skills is to know that natives link words together. And this is the way they manage to speak so quickly. They often pronounce words or even phrases all together as if it was a single long word. Look at this sentence. That time was amazing, do you remember? That time was amazing, do you remember? This sentence is divided into three chunks of language, that means three groups of words put together. That time was amazing, do you remember? That time was amazing, do you remember? So if you're expecting to hear a native speaker pronouncing word by word individually, that time was amazing, do you remember? It will be quite hard for you to understand what that person is saying. So how can you be prepared to hear linked words when someone speaks? I'm going to mention three main situations in which natives naturally link words. The first one is when there is the same consonant sound. The second is when there is a consonant and a vowel sound together. And the third, when there are two vowel sounds together as well. Do you remember this phrase from the sentence before? That time. How many times can you hear the t sound? That time. That time. Correct. Only once, because this sound is shared by both words. So when there's a consonant sound at the end of a word and the same one at the beginning of the next one, we pronounce it only once as a way to link both words together. That time. That time.
And at that time.
Another example can be red dress. Both words have the D sound, so a native would naturally say red dress, red dress.
Very nicely dressed woman with a red dress.
And our last example is cheap place. Both words have the P sound. So the most natural way to say this is cheap place, cheap place.
As you can imagine, Silicon Valley is not a cheap place to live.
Second group. Do you remember this little phrase from before? Was amazing. Was amazing. As you can see, we are linking words here by connecting a consonant and a vowel sound together. This is a technique natives use all the time when a word ends in a consonant sound and the next one starts with a vowel sound. Was amazing. Was amazing.
And it was amazing.
Another example can be an incredible idea, an incredible idea. Again, we are connecting consonant and vowel sounds together. Now, watch out because we are talking about sounds, not letters. So don't worry, for example, about the E letter at the end of incredible. It doesn't sound, so we don't consider it at all. An incredible idea, an incredible idea.
What an incredible idea.
And our last example is take it or leave it. Take it or leave it. As you can see here, natives turn the T sound into kind of an R, soft sound. Instead of take it or, they rather say take it or leave it, take it or leave it.
I think we should demand less take it or leave it.
And for our last group, we have vowel sounds. Natives sometimes link two vowel sounds together, as in this sentence. He asked me to go out. He asked me to go out. Something that natives very commonly do is that they use the sound ie or the sound ue in between those two vowel sounds. Listen, for example, he asked, he asked. We don't hear he asked, we hear he asked, he asked.
And then he asked me why I stayed after school.
The other example would be go out, go out. A native wouldn't say go out, but with the W sound in between. Go out, go out.
The money goes in, but it can't go out.
So when you are aware of the fact that natives link words and sounds together all the time, it makes it a lot easier to know what to expect when you are listening to them speaking. My tip number two for you to understand native speakers better is focus on content words. You don't have to understand every word they say. You just have to focus on a few very important words that will give you a general overview of the conversation. So instead of getting stuck on one word that you didn't understand and stop listening because you're panicking and trying to think what the word means, you should continue listening and try to get some content words. Content words are very important words full of content, which normally are nouns, verbs, and adjectives. And then we have something called function words, which we will see in our tip number three, which don't seem to be so important. Look at this sentence, guys. As we said before, natives wouldn't say, "Do you wanna grab a coffee?" So we need to train our hearing to get a sentence as a whole piece of language, focusing, of course, on content words. Do you wanna grab a coffee? Do you want to grab a coffee? So don't worry about not getting all the other not so important words, because natives tend to pronounce them faster. That's fine, just focus on content words. Do you want to grab a coffee? Wanna grab coffee are the three words you have to hear. With this, you'll know what the other person's talking about. Do you want to grab a coffee?
Do you want to grab a coffee?
We finally made it to a new decade. Finally, new decade. With these three words, we know what is happening. We finally made it to a new decade.
We finally made it to a new decade and so much has changed.
So focusing on content words, you'll be able to figure out more or less what the other person is talking about. And my last tip for you is be aware of reductions. Because natives link words together and give more importance to content words, they also tend to reduce those words that are less important. Those less important words or function words, as we called them before, are articles, a, on, the, conjunctions, and, but, if, prepositions, on, out, to, pronouns, you, him, her, or helping verbs, be, do, have. So when natives use these words in a sentence, they reduce them and make them shorter. For example, this one. You wouldn't hear a native saying, "I have been looking for you." You'd rather hear, "I've been looking for you." I've been looking for you. Have becomes v. For becomes v. And you becomes you. I've been looking for you.
I've been looking for you.
I've been looking for you.
I've been looking for you.
Same here. You won't hear, "You have to let it go." You'd rather hear, "You have to let it go." You have to let it go. Have to becomes have to. Let it becomes letty. You have to let it go.
You have to let it go.
You have to let it go.
They women have to let it go.
Or the last one. What do you do? A normal native speaker would say, what do you do? What do you do? Do you becomes do. What do you do? What do you do?
So what do you do?
What do you do?
And what do you do?
So that's why if you're expecting to hear fully pronounced and clear words when natives speak, chances are that you'll get a bit lost. So keep this in mind and know what to expect when listening to native English speakers. Here are three secrets to improve your listening comprehension skills. If you enjoyed this lesson, like it, share it with your friends, and have a look at our social media, where you can find lessons, quizzes, games, and much, much more. Remember that you can have a speaking class with me and people from all over the world if you click the link I've left in the description box for you. And that you can continue improving your English if you have a look at the techniques I've left here for you. What to do in your everyday life and techniques to remember vocabulary in English. Thanks for watching and I'll see you very, very soon. Practice this, enjoy it and share it.